to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining.
Ah, oh, come on.
Team secrets turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome Vegas back. It's Star Ladder Season 13, the Star Series, which is now paired up with iLeague. And we are into Day 2 of Phase 2 action now. And we're going to be hopping into Group B. It's Team Secret making their Star Ladder debut, if I'm not mistaken. And they're going to be going up against Vega Squadron. And Vega Squadron already had their debut series, which was yesterday when they took down the CIS Rejects. It took them 3 games to do it, but they got the job done. And now we'll see what they can do against, well, the team that's probably the powerhouse favorite of the group. It's Team Secret here. I'm Kyle Guy for Beyond the Summit. I'm not going to be casting alone, though. I got, hopefully, returned now, back my good buddy Clairvoyance from the Great Unknown. Clairvoyance, are you there? Wonderful. You don't sound too staticky, and everything seems great. I got a fun stat for you that was thrown my way from the wonderful Ben Knoxville, stats lord, as we all know. Can you believe, Clairvoyance, that this is going to be Mag's 1,000th pro game of Dota? He is now tied for 10th most games along with Fata. So, it's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Behold the horn of Magnus.
Oh, for sure. Oh, for sure. What do you think would be like the three off the bat? For me, it's like maybe Clock. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm with you on that. Maybe as of recent, it was maybe a bit more Broodmother, but so far, speaking of which, Broodmother has not been acknowledged, but we haven't hit the second phase yet. But there was a period there where Vega were like, oh, Brood is working for us. We're first phase picking it. And it worked for them in their matchup against Secret. That's right. This is a bit of a run back when they went off against Secret at ESL 1 New York. So.
Gyrocopter!
Vega squadrons turn to ban. Team Secrets turn to ban.
I do want to say they did meet before then, but definitely they put on their strongest showing at ESL 1 New York. And even yesterday, I was casting with Scant, and we were watching their series run against CIS Rejects, and we were just kind of like, this doesn't seem like the dominant Vega we were seeing from ESL 1 New York. Now, don't get me wrong, Game 3, they looked marvelous, and they came out with the series win, but this is Vega that took down Secret. This was Vega who was, like, slated to be one of the best at the major. Clairvoyance, you gotta remember, they took down OG, who became the champions twice in the group stage. And now they're like, you know, going 3-game stretches with teams like CIS Rejects, and I don't know. I think people are going to start looking at them under a magnifying glass now, just to see really where they are, and throw them into the category with your alliances and your Navis if they're back, if they're forward, or whatever it is.
Team Secrets turn to.
But here we are with draft at hand. Dazzle Magnus is going to be the opening here. But they're not going to have the precious Ember Magnus combo. It had already been banned first from Vega. This comes along with respect towards the ban on the Meepo from Wii. They get rid of the AM and even a Huskar now, which is definitely a worthy phase two band, seeing the Dazzle already grabbed up. But they're going to pick up a Tusk Gyrocopter. Remaining. Very, you know, like what we saw from the last series. Very similar to what we saw.
Team Secrets, turn to pick.
Caffeine War. I didn't notice. I guess I just figured he was going to have some random ass name, but I never really looked at it. And that is definitely not how you spell caffeine. But just to his credit, Claire, I'm going to do him the favor. And I'm going to Google Caffeine Warrior as he has it spelled. It could be a crazy anime. I'm not too sure. Nope, it's definitely not. He definitely misspelled it, Claire. So it's definitely a him thing. Everyone, please be gentle on the poor guy, because I'm sure he's going to be hearing a lot about it soon. All right, well, not enough caffeine, apparently. So Bane, a classic secret third pick here, is going to be it.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Queen of Pain. Team Secrets.
Now you cry. Now you plead for your support. Do something about this. Do something about this. Like, it's, I like to be that Bane and piss off the other mid laner, so I can't imagine. Yeah. Oh, by the way, it looks like Knoxville heard us talking about Mag and his top heroes. So if we were curious, just between us, on what his top picks usually are, most of the games, Centaur, 61 picks, Clockwork, 129, but Bulba is still nipping at his heels, apparently, with 119 games on Clockwork. So apparently he does still have a pretty high Clockwork rating, maybe against almost everyone. So that's impressive. What is he playing here, though? Let's segue that. Do you think he's more of a Tusk player? I don't see him play Tusk too often. So I don't know if Vega are going to be opting to have this more in the, you know, hands of someone like Solo or Seema, or if this is just going to be Mag playing it in the offlane. Do you think there's a preference here? Oh, the plot thickens now, and it looks like this will be a Misery Magnus, which I feel like it is more often than not, though Weeha has shown he can't play it in the mid lane if necessary, but in the hands of Misery, can't help but feel like the early judgment call is that this is a Magnus more so for the Empower than his RPs. And if you've got someone like Ember who's not available, what are our next best options here for maybe Envy? Remaining. Now, we still have to wait to go through Vega's next pick, but they have the luxury of the last pick. So do we know Envy to play a lot of like Slark, maybe a Jug? What was the other one I was just thinking about? Phantom Assassin was the other one I was thinking about. The guy has a set for Phantom Assassin, for God's sakes. It could be something. It could be something. But this one last pick here could sway it. We'll see. Rubick is going to be the grab.
Team Secrets, turn to Ban.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Vega squadrons, turn to ban.
Jug's going to be removed, and it's obvious they want to get someone who can put on the boxing gloves and swing. They banned out the clockwork, who could prevent them from really kind of interacting in the fight. Having to deal with those cogs is a real pain in the butt. And, I would say Slark is probably the safer bet in being able to be elusive and get the job done, and PA's like, I'm Eternal Envy, and I'm picking PA. I that would just be my split down the middle for two of it, or maybe they have something else in mind. But we can try to think a step ahead for them now, for Vega, when you anticipate that you are going to be going against something like this. Do you try to change course at all, or... It seems like they've already put a bit of a commitment here that Gyro is going to be their all-in for the later game. And, oh, they actually did go with something a bit different here. Ursa! Ursa the Grab. I had heard murmurs that it's something that Secret have been toying with a bit. But here it is in the limelight now.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Do you think it's worth like going the extra mile and let's say they like try to flip the script up a bit and keep Tusk in like a support position to get Mag something else? I mean, I don't know if Mag's ever played an offlane Queen of Pain or something, but getting like extra kiting potential, like a Viper, let's say, that happens to still be out there, or...
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Beastmaster.
Oh. Mag here we were talking about earlier. And it looks like he's going to be sporty. Get your lockdown regardless of BKB or not. So great crowd control. And of course the vision. The vision might be just a big, big thing here. Because Secret obviously have a pretty damn good Dire Roche kind of a lineup. And you want to make sure you can kind of keep in check Ursa if he's farming out on the side. Trying to sneak in and do a bit of a Roche play. It'll be nice to have this Beastmaster on your team. So, based on draft here, Claire, I mean, what are you thinking? Secret pulled together a lineup that seems very, well, to be honest, Secret-esque. But Vega, a team that has been kind of faltering a bit, finding their groove back in the meta once more. Do you think they've pulled together a lineup that might be able to kind of give Secrets, who are going to be coming to this favorites, a run for their money?
10 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle.
Which, I can't help but be a bit concerned then if that's the case for someone like Secret when they usually put lineups together. And for, like, Misery and his Mag, it's like, well, he's here more for the utility capability that he's got. And, you know, not really making sure he lands all these crucial RPs. But when those RPs become so crucial, you gotta hope that Misery's going to be on his A game for this one and could get the setups that are necessary for someone like Ursa to kind of knock the whole team down. I am getting a side note here, I guess since we have the pause and the time to check it. Do you want to just double check and make sure your open mic team is still turned on and that they can hear you with Dota TV?
The threshold's been like really, it's been messing up for me. I don't know, it's hard for me to figure it out, so I apologize for that for all the viewers and everybody else, but it's just like Dota, how Dota mic picks up and Mike picks up, it's like completely different.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So
don't even get me started about the differences and where the Dota TV mic could be improved a bit. But I guess to play on the safer side, you can always put the threshold much further to the left, if not maybe even all the way down if it's necessary. But looks like we had a bit of a disconnect to start things off. Reconnection here. The memory leaks have been plugged, I suppose, and we're going to get back and underway. Already early emphasis here for Mag wants to make sure he has a good time in his off lane with a ward in hand. Long block of the camp, very deep ward for Secret. They are already busy moving as a full posse here down to the bottom lane in hopes for a good level one setup against Vega. Will they get it, though? We'll see.
Find out more at 11.
Yeah, right? Pasha. The Rocket Raj. Forecast for danger here. But look at this. Pilot Eye's already in. Lands out the sleep. Skewer him back home to buddies. And Seema is dead. All right. So there's your first blood, and it's going to go to Misery. Easy sleep, skewer setup.
Seema the slain as he goes down before the creeps.
Or Sayama, however it's supposed to be pronounced, but I still don't
is that
pronounce
right?
properly. I don't.
Ever since ESL, he's always been John Seema to me.
Yeah, well, the plays certainly back it up.
Yeah.
But ever since that whole like debacle about Noon and no one, then everyone's just like, yes, there's no one. We call no one, then I'm just going to call it as I see. I figure if the players have a problem with it, they can come up to me and be like, hey, good sir. Listen, by the way, my name is pronounced like this, and I'd be like, you know what? Thank you for the respect, and not just kind of letting it happen and feeling very awkward about it.
Yeah.
Just tell
I'm
me.
Sure he's fine with no one.
But here they are. Now it's Queen of Pain versus Lina. Now this doesn't feel like the current meta right here, Claire. This is a bit of a throwback of lane matchups, but what are we thinking here? Weehaw, we know, is very formidable with his Meepo, his Wind Ranger, and occasionally we'll pull out the Lina at time, but do you feel like no one has kind of got him outclassed here?
I think so far he's looking pretty good. I mean, it's like one creep into the lane, so it's hard to tell, but you know, Weehaw was forced in to get the stun because of that level 1 engagement. And Lina these days, I don't think you want the level 1 stun. I think you want level 1 Dragon Slave followed by level 2 Fiery Soul, because the stun, it just not only does not do enough damage, but you really want to be able to attack faster in this kind of lane. Intel versus Intel, right click versus... He's doing a lot of good harassing here.
No one will have to start going through those tangos early. I'll still both share tangos in hand here for Wii as he gets up the extra level, and we'll bump into the Dragon Slave. And Vega could decide instead to look to capitalize on what some may consider Secret's weaker lane in Misery, but he has the skewer back, always necessary just in case. But as you can see, Solo already dishing out some nice early harassment damage. And you always have to fear of the, you know, snowball rocket barrage getting caught outside the creeps, and next thing you know, you're going to be soaking up a bit too much damage. But with the benefit of that first blood, he gets early boots and he has early consumables, and things seem to be a-okay for Misery as it stands. While Mag is still just kind of stuck in a bit of a rut here. It looks like they found his ward there, Claire. They had a sentry plan on the other side, and now he's kind of stuck in the dark.
Mm-hmm. He'll just have to stay in the vicinity of his tower for the time being. Even though they are defensive supports, they are missing, and you always have to respect range right clicks. Especially if the Ursa gets in range, he's going to be able to Earth Shock him down and slow him down for a set of followed guaranteed right clicks. It's definitely a very scary situation for him.
Dirty little Mag denied the bounty rune with his wolf. Not going to allow the Bane to pick that one up. And we're back at mid lane now, where Solo picked up that bottom rune, which happened to be an invis. And Wee's like, something fishy. Do they have the vision down that bottom rune? I don't think they did. So he just knows that someone's missing and the rune was down there. And his game sense is tingling, and it's tingling for the better. So he'll play defensively. And what he doesn't know is Solo's already going to be heading on the way out. So good heads up for him.
8k game sense right there.
Mag as well has to be very defensive in the lane still. You know, Bane constantly missing. What they don't know is he's just making up some stacks here, some sweet stacks for them to farm through. Very easy for the Lina. But it's very steady as she goes from both sides. No opportunities really opening up. You'd think that, especially with this bottom lane from Vega, they would hope to get a significant grab here onto Misery, but they have not able to do so yet, and he has to head all the way back to the fountain.
He's also got 700 gold already. I'm not sure if he wants to go for a bottle, but if he chooses, he can do that, and he'll have enough money for a TP in a few moments. But just going back to the offlane situation for the Radiant, This is one of the reasons I felt that maybe not Beastmaster, but Earthshaker might have been better. It gives them similar amounts of lockdown and damage. Of course, Beastmaster generally gives more presence, but ES would have had level 3 guaranteed by now, just Fissure blocks. And these defensive supports, they really won't have much to do other than just stare him down while he's farming under the tower. So he's gonna start farming up, or stacking up the Ancients rather, with his board, but that's already been scouted out by Pilot Eye, who's dropped a Sentry Ward. So no more to that, and again, Max still level 1, still struggling.
And it's just nice heads up from Secret. You know, they recognize with Beastmaster not being able to get a lot that that could be a side bank account that Vega are looking to hold. They spot it out, and oof, Misery heads to the rune trying to get it, but it was already picked up from Seema. Oh, he's gonna cliff him? Oh, that would be just terrible. Nope, not gonna be able to get close enough for it. Instead, though, a nice pullback into the rest of Vega. Tries to go for a TP, that's not happening. Seema will finish him off with a Fade Bolt, and Vega will even the score now 1-1 as they get themselves on the board. Radiant's
top tower is I think that death itself wouldn't have been too bad if he didn't use the TP. Now that he used the TP, he'll have to walk back to lane. It's like it's basically another lane wave he's missing. But it was okay because no one had to come, and I guess he sort of missed time in the lane, so to speak. And it also showed three heroes on the side of Vega. And Secret were kind of worried where Vega was for the time being, and no one's blinking to try and counter the Observer Ward, but not quick enough on the trigger.
So what did Secret get out of it? Because they recognized so many were able to... in the mid lane there for Vega. He did push pretty hard in the top lane, and got some mild damage onto the tower. You know, Puppy's able to kind of continue to make stacks and, you know, equal out the lanes a bit more. I just don't know if Secret were able to get the most out of it here, but this does allow Wii to get back in the groove for his mid lane. But Solo just continues to just be floating around here. His presence isn't really necessary in the bottom lane, so he's just continuing to look around for opportunities.
Yeah, but the fact that he showed himself mid actually allows Misery to walk in for the EXP range that he just got there. Whereas if he was still missing out, imagine Misery would have stayed at his tower until there was some more intel. It really is a lot of, Dota is really a lot of, buying games coming to Vision and stuff, and as we see, no one, he sees nothing at the... nothing at top right now, so that's why when the Bane showed up, he immediately just back, thinking that with Bane, Lina, possibly plus one, he would go down. But yeah, both teams are like in a high alert state at the moment.
Misery not even going back to his lane yet. We'll make a side stack for his team in the meantime.
Oh, the 6-minute rune though.
6-minute rune. Got Weeha with his Laguna.
Yeah, it looks like no contest. Yeah, there's no contest coming. Coming out of Solo there. I thought he was going to go for it, but he decided to just stack up the neutral instead. A wise choice.
No one is free to get the rune at the top, which happened to be a DD. He'll snag that one up for now. Doesn't opt to get the Sonic Wave at his level 6 yet, so he pushes on for level 7 here. And it doesn't look like Weeha is going to get an opportunity to really put the Laguna to use as of yet. Just one slow play happening here. Look at Pylai die so deep, blocking out the camp, preventing them from even doing anything over there. Creeping over now, trying to find maybe Solo and passing between one lane or the other. He has very deep wards committed now, and he's just kind of being the gatekeeper for his own lane.
They spotted each other out. Yeah, I think Pi didn't want to get scouted out, but Bane is definitely one of the heroes that can do this. As you see, just this Nightmare TP. Even if he gets caught, he can Brain Sap and possibly fight. No other support, or very few number of supports, can just walk into the enemy woods at nighttime 6 minutes and do the kind of thing.
Yeah. That's just perfect kind of Pi hero if you're just looking to get someone to cause mischief and dive deep.
Yep.
You know, him, Bounty, whatever. It's just a Pi kind of a thing to do. Oh, Shar's not going to connect properly on Misery. He'll be on the other side and be able to walk back to the tower. An opportunity that is gone there for Solo, who had been hunting, trying to hope to get a setup for his team, but those opportunities are not there. Well, yeah,
with the snowball, maybe it would have been different, I think.
Fortune not happening, maybe worried about the skewer back mid lane. Oh, Pi hits with the scream, and now he saps up some damage from Solo, but ultimately the sleep comes off. No one's going to get the kill there, and
forces a TP.
All she wrote.
See, more intel. I think they recognize now if Dazzle's showing up to sap EXP and try to follow up his TP, then they must realize that the Lina's just farming the woods. I'm not sure if they're going to contest, but I'm sure they have the intel. Oh, Misery versus no one at bottom.
Got it. Glitches out. Sonic Wave, he has it now. Misery to the high ground, and he'll be able to TP away to safety. Nothing to stop him, so looks like he'll be good. And we're still 2-1. Very mild 3 kills only at 8 minutes in. Both teams a lot of emphasis, and as you said, very disciplined. Very nervous and scared. not looking to take any not too many risks with the given intel that they've been able to see it on the map. Envy will just take the time to do a bit of side farm, but we'll see. It looked like maybe Weeha's not going to really find the opportunities to use the Laguna at this rate, it looks like, until he finishes out his Yules.
Honestly, even if he gets his Yules, I feel like this is one of those games where he might be inclined to use it defensively. Because anytime he goes on somebody, there might be like a snowball, lift, follow-up coming from the high ground or something like that. There's a lot of things he has to watch out for. And I imagine if he wants to utilize the Yules aggressively, they need to make a smoke rotation for it with the Bane and possibly with the Ursa. Speaking of the Ursa, yeah, he's here now. Are they looking for something right now, or...?
I don't know. Now he phased in Morbid Mask, he's just gonna pass on through and hit either the top lane or just jungle farm along the way. A couple of stacks here to work with, but yeah. It's not any sort of early Roche play coming in here. I don't think that's gonna pass against this Vega squad. So I can't help but be a bit nervous for the potential of this Ursa. We have yet to see him really dig his claws into anyone.
Yeah, I'm trying to look for the smoke count on the Dire shop, but unfortunately I can't see. Oh, I can see it now. Yeah, there's only two smokes, and I don't see any on the heroes. So I think he might have solo smoked himself and realized, like, decided otherwise or decided against it. I think he wanted to Roche.
Maybe they saw the bird go in. There's a bird there now, but yeah, that definitely something raised concern and forced Secret to kind of step off from the game plan and do something else. And it looks like another big stack here from Misery. All, of course, being spotted out. Vega will know this is happening here, and we'll see if they decide to do anything about it. And, well, for Mag, it looks like it's straight to the Zookeeper build-up, if you will. Straight to Staff of Wizardry. He's going right for the Necro build. Yeah. Gotta get the book.
So they're going. They're going again. And he's already charged up the overpower, so this is the one that they'll commit to, I think.
Here he goes. This is the chance, the timing window that ain't too big, ain't too crazy, but the vision ain't there from Vega. And he starts going to work. Puppy's going to be helping out with this Nova Medallion in hand. Some Vega here at the bottom, but none of them seem to be the wiser. And Meg has a bird, but it is on the other side of the river. So it looks like they're going to be able to get away with this one, Claire. Might cost him a tier 1 bottom, but they're just smoked up waiting for an opportunity. It looks like it's going to be on Misery.
Oh my gosh.
Well, they'll get Misery, but they'll quickly realize that they didn't get Roche. Secret got that one, and...
Yeah, well, they're okay with it. You know, I thought Vega would have made the most next level play by smoking just under their tower, or just in front of their tower, and going straight to the Roche pit. And Gyrocopter with the cooldown might have given them vision to just take the Roche and fight, and take Roche as a result, but... No, in the end, they just get Misery, and again, Secret, I think, they're pretty content with that.
I would imagine so. Pileidai top lane, get some solo time for himself to push up to his level 6 and get his Fiend's Grip in order. And, well, you can actually say the same case for Mag. Poor little Mag here is still trying to get a level 6 on his offlane Beastmaster here. You compare that over Misery's level 6.5 on his Magnus here with RP in the ready. Still looking to save up for his Arcane Boots himself. But all these level 6s starting to come online now. The mid-game approaching here, Claire. Is there a team that might particular taking team fights and have the significant advantage over the other? I just still don't foresee Secret being that team.
Yeah, I still think Secret...
Maybe it is. Maybe they want to put the Aegis to use. Is it an offensive Aegis here to use, or do you think they're going to use it more defensively to continue to farm the map?
I think they have to use it offensively. As you said, like, their draft kind of... it kind of relies on Vega going on them
DC
first.
From TeamSpeak? Oh, hello.
I think, pardon me, I was still around, but zoning out for a second. I did want to mention that. I think they do want to play it aggressively, and, you know, he blinked to anticipate possibly a Beastmaster sticking around. As you said, man, Secret, their lineup looks like they want to play reactive, but I'm not sure if Vega's willing to give them any of that.
Radiant structures are bottom lane. Vhagar here. They're looking to possibly swarm. Puppy and company are nearby. They're going to get the early weave onto Wee and a full rocket barrage here for Puppy. He's going to have to pick someone to grave, and he doesn't pick anyone. He ends up going down, but look who shows up. It's going to be Envy now, looking to roll deep. Gets Ursa onto Gyro. Gyro going to be taken down, and now Solo rolls in, gets the Walrus Punch. Envy the one in trouble. This is going to be for his Aegis, and there it's going to expire. Pi goes down. Misery charges in. He still has RP. Can't get a good use out of it. We'll use it there, but it's only for Seema. Envy comes back, gets the kill follow-up, but it's going to be Vega coming out huge here in a five-man wipe in the bottom lane. Six, if you count the Aegis.
Yeah, I don't know. I think just by draft, again, Secret, they have to play super reactive this game. I don't think they have an option. Vega's lineup is geared towards so much more aggression, but it also comes so much easier to them, not only because the Beastmaster Hawk providing them vision at all times, but also their ability to just naturally push out waves. And Secret, they're always going to be in vision. And when you're playing against Map Pack, pardon me, no one almost died with a nice snowball coming out of solo.
Very nice.
It's, yeah. It, again, they have so many tools to not only mitigate the fight, but start the fight with so much advantage in terms of life point. So much long range nuke, so much AoE, so much vision. It really is in their favor.
I'm surprised they're not also pushing to get something like a, maybe even a mech on their team. I guess it's something solo could still go for, but I guess with just enough defensive tools, they don't really need to.
I think,
worry
yeah,
about
I think
Link
is just fine, right? Because we see the snowball, what it does. It ruins the Lina's combo, and it can possibly ruin the Magnus's RP. It's, again, like the Secret is so reliant on these spells connecting, and snowball might just put this connection from happening. And
man, quick work on Puppy in the bottom lane. Alright, got the whole thing, just an easy roll in, uppercut, minor heal bomb, fade bolt, and Dazzle goes down without being able to get Grave off.
Yeah. In the meantime, top tower is getting pressure, so maybe they'll get something out of it. Maybe they won't. Solo's gonna try to drop a shard, I think, and I think that's the end of that.
Yeah, Envy has the boxing gloves on, if you will, the Empower, but I'm still not finding this Ursa to be a huge threat. I just feel like his shortcomings are still gonna be a bit of a problem. Yeah, he got that bird, though. Got that bird. Well, he's going back up and away. Just worried with the shards, the snowballs, everything coming out. He's not going to have the easiest time finding a target. And if you're putting a lot on an RP, and right now he's like, oh, free farm for me. But they're just going to take his life. Like, what were you doing? You're taking our stack, boy. We're going to take you.
That was a, you know, that was a typical envy death, I think.
Yeah.
That was pretty typical. So unfortunately he got caught out there, but he saw the greater amount of farm available as opposed to saving his life. Kind of impulsively decided that maybe I can take this neutral before they can do anything.
It's like you see a dollar in the street and he just ran out there and got hit by a car. It was real bad.
Yeah, something like that. Not even a bait, really. It just happens. Like, it's like a regression of events.
Oh, commitment, wow. In. Big sonic wave. And quickly, Puppy's going to be going down. The follow-up is getting Pilot Eye in the Bane. And a tier 1. Ben Vega out in full force here in game number 1. And it doesn't stop there. Book spawned out from Mag, and they're going to go right for the tier 2, and there's really nothing that Secret can do about it. Envy's back now, but he can't offer a lot to stop this siege.
Yep, looks like the tier 2 is going to go down for free. Envy's just going to stare them down for the time being and pick up the lingering. I think this is somewhat expected. He's gonna go in for some of these creeps here, but
he just killed a Necro Book, and he's half dead. He's gonna die. Oh, the shards! Don't block him in. That
he's going
been
in.
Disastrous, but he's still committing in. But they got Puppy nearby. He's got Grave. Oh my goodness! Oh, they got him down with the help of a Fade Bolt coming in from Seema. Full Fiend's Grip gonna be on Solo, but he gets the Walrus Punch off. He will get dropped down, but it's still a happy trade here for Vega. Oh man. Fortunate Envy deaths back to back for him. 14-4 for Vega.
Yep, and you know, Seema the Slayer almost has a Blink Dagger. So that's a 17-18 minute 5 position support Rubick that's about to pick up Blink. And I think, in terms of net worth, I expect them to all like take over the top 7 positions pretty convincingly. It's, no, Solo died once, and I guess Mag is ahead of because of it. But yeah, they're looking pretty damn healthy in terms of Secret Smoke.
And Secret were the team that were able to kind of sneak in and get the Roche at nicely timed and everything, and things kind of were going according to plan, but things have quickly.
Their team fight is really, really hard, man. And again, yeah. We have to consider that, like, this Mag has to hit a nice 2-man RP at the very least, and then Dazzle has to get a clutch Grave off. Bane cannot be interrupted on the Fiend's Grip. It's just so many things that they have to execute well. And Call Guy, as you said, with the draft, you know, Secret, they like to pick a lot of these Secret-esque heroes, and they have to execute most of the time. It's every time I see them play, I make of course, a lot of people make EG comparisons to them. But if I have to say, like, Secret are the team that they're like the only team that can win heroes, and Misery goes down at mid. Very simple pick up in the river there, but they really rely on themselves to execute well. And EG are sometimes, they're the team that wins with a lineup that no other team would win. Secret have their own niche in that regard. This is like a classic case of it going the exact opposite way, I think.
We'll have to see how Secret are adapting the game plan and finding any sort of outs, or maybe just holding back and not showing any sort of weakness and trying to take advantage of any sort of weakness that Vega could show. Maybe a bit of a overextension or getting a bit too greedy. Maybe they could punish on that and hope for a fight to kind of snap the net worth back in their favor. But yeah, as it feels right now, it's looking pretty damn swell for Vega. Early look at the net worth graph, 7,500 in their favor, 4K for XP. And they're off they go. I mean, no one is about to have his BKB, for God's sakes, on this Queen of Pain. And there
yeah,
you see
their outs are like completely reliant on the enemy and pretty much up to chance at this point. I don't think they can do any more than just trying to push out the lanes best they can and minimize the feeds. It's gone to that point where they just have like absolutely no map control. Even with the smoke that they had, it's not so much a failure in that they fed kills or like lost another engagement, but it's that even after the smoke, not only did they get nothing, but they lost even more map control. It's only gonna get harder from here on, but the silver lining in all this, I guess, is that Eternal Envy is soloing up Roshan.
Yeah, he's got some decent damage in. Pulled out the ult early. I don't play a lot of Ursa, but I always figured he'd pull out the ult near the end and just finish it off, but it doesn't matter. Look at him chunk that thing down. He's got it. Aegis in hand. He's got extra life. Certainly needs it. Handed away a couple of lives earlier, unfortunately, but now he can play a bit more safe for finding that farm. But Vega heading up the other direction.
It's one of those Aegis games, though, like where I would say Vega probably don't care. If Envy ends up in a place where they want to be, they'll probably just kill him once and stack on top of him just to kill him twice or something. It's gotten to that point where the advantage is that great for them, or at the very least, they probably feel that confident. Who can blame them? Ag is on his way to book 3 already. Usually this guy gets it by 20 minutes. And that's something like a trademark of his. It's very good. But this game he's a little bit hindered. Surprisingly, even though he's snowballing. And I think it's a product of his laning phase. Had a very, very slow start in the lane there.
Well, he manages to play great catch up. It's one of his top heroes.
Yep.
And his 1000th pro game reminder. So he's hoping to get a win on that 1000th game. We'll see. It's on good track to do so. And for Secret, a more execution-reliant kind of a draft they've thrown together here. They just got to hope the stars can come together. And they'll be able to get this opportunity they're hoping for. You know, the last thing they had going for them was a recent pickup of the Aegis here. 3,300 gold, though, in store for Envy. What do we think we're going to grab here? He's already got the essential mobility tool of his Blink and has the Vlads on hand here. Is he going Basher, Abyssal Blade kind of fighting lineup, or does he need to consider tanking up a bit more?
I think he doesn't really have options. I think it's either BKB or Basher for sure. The Basher would help him transition, and some of those lucky Bash kills that he wouldn't otherwise. But the BKB would also... I don't know if it would guarantee his survival. In the end, I think he's just going to get kited by the boar and a whole bunch of other things anyway. It would certainly give him enough of a buffer to deal the damage he wants to, at least for a short duration of time. So he does offer the BKB, I think. And here's the five-man smoke. I think if Secret, if they take a good fight and take the tier 1, they're back in, sort of. Tier 1's already at 22 HP, and I think Vega's already converging together with a smoke of their own. So this Secret fight's going to be the last one, possibly.
There they go. They're about to converge. Solo dancing out in front for Vega here. Might scout him out. Envy with that Aegis, happy to move in first, loses half of his life. There's going to be the... Oh, they quickly cancel it out. Nice silence there, and that means Envy's going to be stuck out on his own. That's going to be the Aegis down, and... Well, it looks like Pasha was looking to move in and catch out some of those backliners, but they're going to wait for Envy here. They step back, Sonic Wave's waiting for him. Gets off the right click, they got the Laguna, they got the kill. The Gyrocopter is going to be going down. And now we set up the Yules here onto your Tusk. He's got the Snowball off, no one re-engages, gets the kill onto... The Magnus, they look back for Envy here. He gets a grave for now, barely alive and well. No one's going to be able to finish off Wii. He gets dropped. Envy steps back, gets a kill on the Seema, then loses his own life as no one clears out another and makes it an ultra kill. At the end of the day, another five-man wipe on the side of Secret, and here comes Vega down the bottom lane.
Yep, and I gotta say, the way Vega executed that fight, it was so well done. They completely dodged the RP for the entire duration. As you called out, man, the instant cancel on the grip, and as I mentioned earlier, it's one of the conditions that they absolutely must adhere to have that Fiend's grip channeling through the duration and let the Bane sacrifice himself to disable one target on Vega, who probably has more farm and more relevance at this point. It's so hard to let that pass, and with Mag just focusing down this Mag was able to roar him through a couple of units there, bring him down very low, and Misery couldn't find a good RP.
And without that proper setup, things just got discombobulated way too fast there for Secret. He had Envy on one side, very aggressive, happy to taunt out forward with his extra life, and the rest of his team kind of got segregated back. It was Pasha ready to move in, but they didn't want to overcommit. And with the team kind of pulled apart so easily and an unfortunate Fiend's grip coming to a quick close, and, you know, it was Vega all day. And now they can go ahead and just march on forward. Imagine they have a gem. Yes, Seema has the gem now. And they can just go ahead and just plant some wards, restrict Secret back for less farm, and eventually just kind of swarm in through their base. Take over at this point. I mean, how are we feeling for Secret with their high ground defense? You have an RP skewer, but I don't know, outside of that, things could get a bit difficult.
Probably their best chance. I did say bottom was the last fight, but they could definitely put up a fight on the high ground if the RP comes in with a nice skewer. And again, it's like the best position they'll have for it. We have a little creep that's stuck in the woods. I don't know how that happened, but I'm sure there were some funky interactions.
Almost scouts out. Oh, he's with the bird. I mean, him and company will be able to see it, but, well, Secret now know one of the few safe places to farm in the meantime while Vega's up in their woods is take over the Vega woods, but look at this Pi who is just trying to maybe get out some safety vision. We'll get scouted out, quickly roared up and taken down, and Vega will regroup towards this top lane and start building in some pressure and forcing Secret back away from this bottom lane and back into their own base. The TPs have already started, and the high ground push is here. Early weave gonna be committed from Puppy, and we'll see if Vega decide to wait out those armor ticks a bit.
Yeah, they're just gonna
pull back.
Yeah, that weave as well as the couple TPs, especially the one initiated by Misery at bottom, it's pretty much their tell to say, hey, let's wait for next Roshan, where we can possibly catch them off, but perhaps we can take it ourselves. We don't want to fight inside the base, so we don't want to give the Magnus a good chance for a comeback, and I think that's the perfect approach to this game, because, again, Secret, they haven't been executing or they haven't gotten the chances to, but they very well can find it. And you have to respect a team of this caliber at any stage in the game.
Oh, without question. Secret will just continue to play the farming game while they can. Envy, after completing out that BKB, has already been forced to use it one time. Is now got about 3k gold build up here. We'll see if he does decide to go with the Basher next and gets that extra necessary lockdown for his team. You know, put that together, you get the help from the Magnus with his Empower, and you hope that with a good RP skewer, he could just kind of clear out the whole Vega squad, but Vega are also a pretty composed veteran group. I don't think they're going to allow any sort of opportunities like that. With proper positioning, sieging into the high ground, staying split up, Seema bottom lane flirting around here with Envy, but I imagine that should be a... It's definitely their ball to drop at this point, and I don't foresee Vega, a team that, you know, is like, oh, biggest throw in the history of the game. So
they have the original 3-2-2 himself.
I like thought of that the second I said it. I'm like, they're not the biggest 3-2-2 team, but I'm like, oh, they have Solo though.
Yeah, they. Oh, that changes things.
He's changed.
I've hyped him up ever since the start, even through that whole incident. I love this guy. He's like, in the CIS scene, I would have to say he was definitely one of the best players for a very long time. And I think, obviously, the incident kind of hurt his image, in a sense that he became more of a meme or a joke kind of thing, but his Dota skill has never faltered.
And he definitely shows a respectable hero pool as well, you know, through ESL 1 New York. He had plenty of games where they were able to play a lot of mind games in the early part of the draft if they had the opportunity to get that early Brood Mama. Of course, we saw that for Mag, but if that was being banned out, they would opt for the Wisp, and we got to see a lot of solo Wisp play. Don't get to see much of it as of recent, but, you know, he has a Wisp, he had a great AA he played during that ESL 1 New York run, and he's been showing more aggressive heroes as of recent, and as you can see now, even a Tuskar play. So it's definitely a world-class player, and Vega are a world-class kind of a team. They didn't get the farthest of the Frankfurt Major, but they're looking to make a emphatic statement now and have a bit of a bounce back here. A big win against Secret certainly would do it.
A lot of these teams, it really does come down to a lot of luck as well as the factors on the day itself. We've seen Vega beat Secret before. We see them almost doing it here so far. Of course, it's somewhat early to tell, but if it progresses the way it did so far, then it looks pretty good in their hands. But yeah, unlucky run into EG at the majors, and you know, things happen. Stars don't align all the time, Coddle.
No, they certainly do not. They were thinking about making a rummage through the Vega woods, but they have second thoughts, probably to their benefit, because Vega had four nearby.
Yeah, they were ready to respond. I do want to point out this pickup on Gyrocopter. Again, a Mantis style, not something we see often on Gyrocopter, usually the SNY, or possibly even a casual Yasha. The Manta is just to disrupt the flow of the multitude of things coming out of Secret. Ursa is one of them, because it is single target. Even with the Empower, you can kind of screw up his chain of attacks. The Magnus, you can actually dodge RP if you have the lucky timing on it. And of course, the Lina Yule combo. If you Yules, and most of the time, they're going to channel the animation to time it how they dodge that as well.
I would love to see those kind of plays. We'll see. He even has the Radiant's spare money now to at least grab the reliable Talisman of Evasion. So he picks up that for now. And we'll see if they look to make an engagement here.
This is the Roshan ping. Yeah, I think they're going to just go for this Roshan. I don't think Secret can give this up. I think they recognize this too, and they probably want to smoke into this. But they're under vision, and I don't think they're aware of it, but they are under vision.
It doesn't look like Secret are going to bother. Or they are. The second I say they pop out of smoke.
I think if they give up Aegis and Cheese here, it's like 100% loss. With the RP,
they're not
going to
make it in time. He'd have to like just... Yeah, no way.
It's too late.
Are they committing in for an aggressive flank play, though? No, they look like... No, we got to get back to base, everyone. Back to base. It's too late. They run all the way back.
And no, I would have to say, even amongst the Tier 1 teams, like a lot of teams would give up at this point, where they would just try to take the fight or flank them out of the pit, as you said. But Secret probably maintains the discipline and says, hey, with a good RP, we can still win. And yeah. I think they're going to go for that.
All right. Let's see if they can do it. That would be one hell of a turnaround. You're looking at over a 10k net worth advantage right now and almost the same on XP. And here is Vega now at the front doorstep of Secret. Pasha holding that Aegis now. Sporting his new Manta, flexes it out here as they get a slow siege onto this Tier 3. The Dream is a huge, huge RP setup here for Misery. No pressure, buddy. And we'll see if he can kind of bring it on in and allow Envy to knock the whole team down. But as expected, Vega are going to be very elusive with their positioning and happy to bait out Pasha in the front as long as humanly possible. Oh, man. They can't wave clear, though. I'll give them that. Secret just annihilate that wave the second it even comes into the high ground.
Yeah. Maybe Vega might think otherwise on this, but I think they should keep up the pressure. At the very least, it looks like they want to split push in all the other lanes first, because it looks like bottom and top have a situation where Secret can get a little bit more vision than Vega wants to give them. Now that we have this this moment, I would like to acknowledge one thing that Envy once told me pretty recently, actually. A month ago after... Not a month ago. After Majors, he had a little block session with me, but he told me he thinks Magnus is one of the best heroes, if not the best hero in Dota. And my concern with these kind of things is always like this. In Dota, there are heroes that have high skill ceilings, and heroes like Invoker that can be played to absolute phenoms.
Yeah.
They really might have no counters depending on how well they're played. But the difficulty of execution, factor in the vision, lack of, or like emotions, coordination, it's very difficult. And now Pasha is going to get executed on here, but with the Manta dodge, should be able to continue sieging.
Sidesteps that skewer here, and you talk about the high skill cap, and it's a test for Misery to get that kind of dream set up here. Pasha very low, though. He made his way out, but not without being battered and bruised. So that tier 3 will ultimately go down, helping with the siege there, the creeps, and of course Mag's Necrobook. His little zoo goes out and starts doing some work. Rax is now exposed. Vega continue to wait far back and away here, allowing their kind of summon units to do all the sieging work for them. They just really don't want to get caught out from Misery here.
They're taking this very slow and very safe. Vega, I mean, Pasha was at 400 HP and he just went to full. I think somebody pulled him to cheese. Yeah, it looks like no one pulled him to cheese. They want to continue the siege this way. I was wondering how they're going to do it because they no longer have rune charges, but Jesus, fine. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Got about 2 minutes left till we get to hear that fancy jingle of the Aegis going down if it is not used. Pylai Dai getting caught with a lot of flat cannon damage, and they just annihilate him with the Sonic Wave, but he's denied himself with the sleep. Very nicely done from Pi. Now there's the cluttered setup. This is Secret's chance to make it work. Can Envy strike it home here? He's looking to man mode up on the Pasha. Pasha quickly turns back and away. They lift up Envy, still able to man mode here. No one trying his best, but they are going to be taking him down. He's going to be forced to use the buyback. This could be Secret's final hurrah. If they can't hold here, they can't hold this game. Envy jumping in, gets a quick kill, taken out solo. Now no one in Mag are going to isolate him. Meanwhile, Puppy, trying to help him out, is stuck up in arms with Pasha, and it looks like this may be it. Envy barely holding on with the just hairs of that grave. And he will go down, and they will call game. Secret will be dropped, and Vega take their game one victory, and on Mag's 1,000th professional game, will get the win.
I'm not even going to bother trying, man. I'm not going to bother trying.
An impressive victory from Vega nonetheless, though, as you say, with Mag's 1,000th game coming out. And, you know, it was really on Secret's hands to try and execute, but Vega looked like they were so dominant ever since that 5-man wipe engagement at the bottom tier 1. It really was in their hands, and they really played this very, very surgically.
I mean, do you feel at all that maybe, and it's hard to say this against a team like Secret,